we've got to get in the United States, we need to tell the truth, don't do that, and that's the truth of God. Absolutely. State your name for the court, please.
Casey Sanders.
Ms. Sanders, where do you reside?
Oh, I live out from the country farm, about a quarter of a mile in my grandfather's house.
So you live, and your grandfather's house, is that in Dawson County?
Yes.
All right. So about the pumpkin farm, I want to direct your attention to August 23rd, 2014. Do you remember that day?
I do.
Do you remember whether there was a Republican rally at the pumpkin farm that day?
There was.
Okay. Now, did you do anything to assist the Republican rally?
I just stood there with my parents as they greeted people as they come in. That's all I did, was speak to everybody.
Now, who are your parents?
Johnny and Kathy Burt.
All right. Now, where were you greeting people at? Do you remember?
Me and my mom were standing next to the counter. It was pretty tight because there was a lot of people in there, but we were standing right next to our front counter.
All right. And at some point, did you encounter the defendant in this case, Ms. Tisdale?
Yes.
All right. Do you remember what happened there?
Yes, I do.
All right. What happened?
She came in and she made it sound like to myself that she was coming in to film for the governor. That's what I thought that was going to be happening.
All right. Did she ask your mama for permission to film?
She did not. She made known what she was going to do.
All right. Do you remember whether she mentioned she was a citizen journalist? Did that come up?
I don't remember. I don't think so, but I don't remember.
Now, did you stay around to listen to any speaker?
I did.
Where were you seated?
There was actually two rows of seats, and I was on about midway back on the right side.
Okay. Do you recall Ms. Tisdale was seated?
The best of my knowledge, she's up on the left side towards the front, or it may be in the middle. I can't remember exactly how the chairs went, but we were all kind of there together, and she was on this side, and I was back here. I think we were in that one.
Now, if you have to do see an encounter, well, let me ask you this. Do you know who Captain Wooten is?
I do.
Was he present there on this particular day?
He was.
Do you remember what he was wearing?
He was wearing a pair of tan pants and a black Dawson County Sheriff's Office shirt.
Did you see if he had a gun on?
I did not.
Okay, did you see if he was wearing a badge anywhere else?
I did not.
All right. Now, did you see an encounter between Captain Wooten and the defendant in this case?
I did.
Can you describe what you saw? What you saw?
Exactly what I saw.
All right.
Okay. Let me tell you how it started out. I heard her yelling. I mean, I seen people to come in and talking to her and going back and forth and, you know, this and that. And then I heard her start yelling. And I seen her lashing around and I seen him take her into the barn, into our main barn.
Now, when you say take her into the main barn, you see how
he just led her in. Let her in by the arm.
Did she seem to be cooperating as they were going
along? Absolutely not. She's lashing around like a fish out of the water.
Did you see whether she swung at him?
I did not.
Did you ever see she kicked him?
I did not.
Okay. All right, so then what happened? Got her in the barn.
Got her in the barn, and I did not come in for a moment or two, but she was screaming to the very top of her lungs. So, of course, I went in. My parents were very distraught because we didn't really know exactly what was taking place. So, I went in to see what was going on, see if I could help with anything or, you know, whatever. And when I got in there, Tommy had her against the counter, standing beside her, and had one of her arms behind her back. And she was still screaming. And I stood at her head and watched everything take place.
How long were you there the entire time?
Not the entire time, no.
At what point did you leave?
When Tony said he had it, he said he was good. I walked out.
Okay. Now, did you see who had the camera there at the counter?
Yeah, she had a camera.
You see whether she was controlling it or operating it anyway?
She was. Not very well, but yes, she was.
Let you left the barn, where did you go, you remember?
You know, honestly, everything's going on, and I honestly don't remember. Let me think about it just a second. I walked out and sat back down and listened a little bit, you know, to what was going on with the speakers, and I couldn't sit still because I was still kind of worried about the things that had taken place, so I went back in the barn. By then, I think she may have already been gone. I don't remember, but it seems like I already had her gone.
Right. When you left the barn, do you remember who I was still in the barn?
I don't. I stood there until Tommy had radioed for somebody to come and get her. And after that, or he got a hold of somebody to come and get her, however they do that. And after that, I walked back out, and then I walked back in, and she was being let out then. So
how long did that?
I really don't know exactly time-wise. It was minutes, I guess. Not very long.
Essentially, would it be fair to say that you were a host along with Mr. and Mrs. Burt?
I would say that we had the property and we allowed them to come up to the property and have the rally, yes.
Okay, well, were you, when I say a host, for example, were you there greeting folks that came in when they came in? And I'm going to just say barn because I don't.
It is barn.
Okay.
Right. Yeah, we were just speaking to people. It's Dawson County people, most of them. We knew a lot of them, and yes, we were speaking to them.
Okay, sure. And those that you didn't know, you were just greeting. Hey, how you doing? Yeah. Welcome. My name is, you know.
Yeah.
And that's kind of what your mom, is it your mom?
Yes, it is my mom. Yes, it is.
That's what she was doing, correct? And there were a number of people coming in and out, the candidates with their folks and other people, correct?
You know, the candidates, yes, they did come in, but I don't remember when they came in or if they came in before, earlier, if they came in. They didn't come in during, not while we were talking to all those folks, no.
Okay.
They may have already been there.
Well.
I don't remember.
Okay. I guess I'll take the I don't remember.
Okay.
All right. Because it's kind of hard to remember those things, right?
Sometimes
especially when you're talking to a number of people that are coming in and out.
Some things are probably true,
sure.
Some things are not.
Well, you remember Senator Perdue coming in, right?
Vaguely.
Okay. And you remember that Ms. Tisdale was holding her camera up, filming Senator Perdue coming in and talking to both your mother and father.
I did not remember that. I did not see her again.
You don't remember any of that?
Nope.
So you didn't understand that she was coming in filming and that she had already been filming other folks. Not just Governor Deal, but everybody.
No, I did not. She made it sound like she was filming for Governor.
Sure. She made it sound like, did she have any Deal items on?
I don't remember.
Did she have any clothing that, or hats or pins?
No, she was dressed differently than everybody else. She had a dress on, nobody else did.
Okay.
That's why I thought she was put together.
Okay. Well, did any of the other governor's folks have dresses on?
Some of them did, and the other are pretty heavily dressed, yeah.
Okay. How was the governor dressed?
He had on a pair of slacks and a shirt and a jacket.
So he was kind of casual.
Yeah, I guess for his position, like he said.
Okay. And did you hear Ms. Tisdale introduce herself to your mother?
I did.
Did you, where were you standing?
Right next to my mother.
Okay. And did you hear your mother talk to her about the pumpkin pie and those things that were available?
You know, I don't remember.
Well, those are the kinds of things that your mother was doing when she was greeting folks, correct?
She was just saying, hey, how are you? To the best of my knowledge, you know. I don't remember about the pie part, I'm sorry.
That's fine. Did she introduce herself?
Ms. Tisdale?
No. Did your mom introduce herself? Say, hi, I'm Ms. Burt. This is my place. I'm glad you could be
maybe
here.
Maybe to some people, but a lot of people already know my parents, so.
Did you hear her talk about the conversation with Ms. Tisdale? To the best of your recollection, if you remember that she introduced herself. Did
my mother introduce herself? That's what you're
yes.
asking.
Yep.
You know, I don't remember,
okay.
Honestly don't.
There were some things that were said as part of this conversation that you either didn't hear or don't remember, correct?
About my mother introducing yes. her name, yes, I don't remember that.
Okay. Were you present for the conversation that your mother had previously with Ms. Tisdale before Senator Perdue came in?
When Ms. Tisdale walked through the
yes.
barn,
uh-huh.
yes, I was standing there. Yes,
okay. Did you hear Ms. Tisdale ask about the restroom and where the restrooms were?
I didn't know.
Did you hear her tell your mother about previous rallies that she had videotaped?
Yeah.
Did you hear her tell your mother about YouTube's that she was going to put the videos on YouTube?
I didn't know.
Did you hear her say that she had placed a number of videos on YouTube previously? Did you ask, or did you hear your mother ask, are you with the governor?
No, nobody asked that.
All right. Did you or your mother or your father or anybody that's within your hearing at this particular point hear anybody say, look, you can't come in and film?
No.
And now, as I understand it, you were in... in the rally when the speaker started.
I was, yes.
Back in the mid-center on the right, mm-hmm. right? And if you were watching the speakers, wasn't Ms. Tisdale directly in front of the speaker?
She was, I could see the camera.
Right, and you could see the camera, and she was holding the camera up, correct?
Very high, like
yeah.
this.
Yeah, holding it kind of above her head, and we've got some pictures of that. You know, Clint Bearden, he started introducing the speakers, correct? He didn't say who he was, you remember?
I don't think he did.
He didn't say you can't film?
No.
Okay. Or he didn't say you can't audio?
I don't think
didn't hear him say
that. I didn't
hear
him say that.
By the way, you know, there is some video of this event. Have you had an opportunity to look at that?
Sorry, I don't, yes.
All right. Now, when the speakers were speaking, Ms. Tisdale was, like you said, the camera was visible. She was about, what, 5 feet away from the candidates?
I would say so.
Okay. And I understood you to say that she was filming until you saw, did you saw? Sorry.
It's okay.
Did you see? Or so. Anybody other than Captain Wooten go talk with Ms. Tisdale?
Yes,
and
I
who
did
you say?
I saw some of the governor's aides and I saw Clint Bearden talk.
Okay. So you saw one of the governor's aides. Do you know what his name was?
I think it was Matt.
Burgess.
I think so.
Okay. How long did that conversation last?
Briefly.
Okay. When did you say briefly? 10 seconds?
Maybe so.
Okay. And then Ms. Tisdale continued to video, right?
Yes.
Then Mr. Bearden went, correct? And where did Mr. Bearden sit, do you know?
I don't remember, I'll just be honest, I'm sorry.
Okay, that's what I did.
I know.
How long did the conversation with Mr. Bearden last?
Not very long, because I was not paying a ton of attention, I was trying to listen to the speaker.
That's fine.
I did see that going on, but I didn't really get to know the timeframe, I don't know.
And do you recall where Mr. Bearden was sitting?
He was sitting down from my parents, yeah, somewhere close to there.
Okay, but when he went to talk with Ms. Tisdale?
I don't know.
Did Mr. Bearden then get up and leave?
I don't think so.
Okay, did there come a time at all when Mr. Bearden and Mr. Wooten went over to talk with Ms. Tisdale? And is that the time all this commotion happened?
After they had spoken to my parents, yes.
They then went back to Ms. Tisdale, and where was Mr. Bearden?
All I remember is all the, everything started happening very quickly.
Very quickly, how fast? After Mr. Bearden and Officer Wooten went back over to Ms. Tisdale, did things start happening?
It was fine until she got so far, and then she started screaming and going ahead.
I'm sorry, perhaps I'm...
Thank you, I understand, I'm tired too.
Mr. Bearden and Mr. Wooten went back over to talk to Ms. Tisdale, correct? And how long did that conversation last? Is it short?
It was too long.
Okay, too long, 10 seconds, 20 seconds?
Something like that.
Okay, in other words, it was a matter of seconds?
It was great.
Okay, and then Ms. Tisdale, she was sitting down during this conversation. All of a sudden, she was lifted up?
I don't remember her being lifted up. I mean, he was trying to escort her.
How did she, so you don't know how she got out?
I honestly don't. I think.
It's fine.
Okay.
She got out of her chair somehow.
Yes.
Correct. And was being escorted out of the barn, right?
She was being escorted into the barn.
Okay, I'm sorry, but I called
out of the shed, the gore shed.
That's what it's called.
Yes.
All right.
Mm-hmm.
So we know what we're talking about.
Yes.
She was being escorted out. Was she yelling?
She started yelling.
Did she say, who are you? Identify yourself.
Okay.
And you could hear her doing that.
I could hear her very clearly.
Sure. Did you ever hear Officer Wooten identify himself?
I could hear Tom because he was trying to keep it.
Did you hear, the balance of that answer, because she doesn't know what he's trying to do. Did you hear him identify himself?
No, but he had a shirt on that said Dawson County Sheriff's Department.
That's right. Did you hear
no,
him?
No, I did not.
Okay. Did you hear her continually request for him to identify himself?
Of course I did. Yes, I did.
And let's put it this way, she's being held, correct, and she's being escorted, in your words, or taken to another location, correct?
Yes, and she's fighting like a fish out of water.
Okay, sure. Somebody's got a hold of her, right?
She's being escorted,
she's
yes.
being forcibly taken to another location.
Escorted, I would draw it.
Well, sure. You know, you would call an escort, and somebody's got a hold of you and is pulling you away, and some man that's, you know, bigger than she is pulling her away, correct? And she's consistently asking, who are you? What do you do? Right?
Okay. Sure, sing it, Dawson County Sheriff's Office.
Okay. Do you know whether she even saw them?
Her. I can't
figure
she's not.
That's what I'm saying.
Sorry.
Did Mr. Wooten come up behind her when he first started talking to her in the board ship?
Nice to her, yes.
I said, did he come up behind her? He didn't get in front of her because you would have seen that on the video.
Maybe he came up beside her and asked her to turn off the camera.
Okay. Okay. That's fine. And she continued to...
Fail.
Did you hear her respond?
I heard her do something, but I couldn't hear what she said clearly. I could not.
Okay. So the answer is no, you didn't hear her respond.
Yes.
And then I understand, once she got to the counter, what do you call it? The counter where you sell things, back at the checkout counter?
The checkout
counter. And you got to the checkout counter sometime later, right?
Not very much later, yeah, because there was a hell of a lady, like you say, going.
Okay, sure. And Ms. Tisdale kept saying, "I got permission from the owner. The owner told me I could."
Yes, she did.
And she was over the counter, the checkout counter, and she was being held there by Ms. Wooten, correct?
Yes.
Okay. And she was consistently saying, "I have permission. I have permission to film." And she continued to say, at least while you were there, did she not, "Please identify yourself."
Yes, but did Ken, his shirt said Dawson.
Did you ever hear him identify himself? Who else was in there at that time?
Me and Tony was in there quite a little, not a long time, a little while by ourselves while
she was... Okay, so it was just you and Tony?
Mm-hmm.
Okay.
And then Bearden came in.
Okay. And who else?
My mother came in and tried to console her.
Okay.
Maya went back out and just stood there. I was kind of just looking out for Tony.
And at that time, you were looking out for Deputy... Wooten?
Well, I mean,
Tony?
Just making sure that everything was, you know, getting calmed down and wasn't
sure.
Going crazy still, you know?
Tony is your, call him Tony, he's your friend?
Tony's been at my kid's school. I've known him for, you know, we're not friends as far as being buddies and hanging out, but we do know each other,
okay.
We're acquaintances.
You know, who else was in there when your mother came in besides you? Was the camera still rolling?
I don't remember at what point the camera went off.
Okay.
It was sometime into her being held, you know, to calm down.
Was her hands handcuffed behind her back?
No.
Was one arm behind her back?
Yes, and Tom kept telling her to calm down.
And the other arm had the camera? Or
yes.
Or maneuvering the
yeah.
Camera? So you think the camera was still going
it was,
at that time?
I don't know that it was on, but I didn't know it was being held up.
Did you have an opportunity to talk with the Dawson County Sheriff's Office?
I did not.
You never talked with Investigator Edwards?
Yes, I did.
Okay.
Calling, that's not true. Yes, it's been 2 years since this has happened.
I know.
Yes, he did call me, and I did talk to him over the phone.
Okay. And he
yes.
Asked you about... You know what happened and everything that you remembered at that time. Okay, good. That's all I have. Thank you, Judge.
Anything further?
Good, Judge.
You may step down.
I'm going to the restroom real quick. See about a minute.
How many witnesses do you have?
We still have two left. Two very lengthy